Oh, that. Okay guys, I've got a really important thing to bring up, and that is, do you think I look slimmer in this top because it's black? It's really important to me because
I never go out of fashion because it's never been in.
I just realised I covered my mic up as well, so can you hear me? Yeah, do I look slim in this or what? What do you think? Let me give you a catwalk. Right, because this for me, this is really important. What do you think? Love the top. Anyway, let's get on to the photography. So, I've got an image, and I've got an image of mine, and I've been waiting to talk to you for quite a while, because I had a couple of walkers come by, and I don't want to vlog while people are coming by, to be honest. So, we've got this cow's parsley. It's beautiful. It's wrapped around the bottom of these trees. On the right-hand side, as we're looking down, I love that scene. And if it weren't for this road and this left-hand side, I'd just take that. And I might still do that, actually. But I think what complements it is this first tree on the left-hand side, which I've actually focused on, has got some cow's parsley around the bottom of that as well, just skirting the bottom just a little bit. It's just dancing there in the wind now. So I focused on that, but it's the right hand side that I love the most, but I think it really complements it. So it balances the image, it draws your eye into it. The little bit of ambient light we've got coming through, it really is a stunning, typical England image, and I'll catch you that now. I'm on f11 ISO 400 because we've got a bit of movement, so I want a little bit of shutter speed there, and I'm on a 40th of a second, which probably isn't enough, to be honest. Get a 60th of a second out of it, that'll probably do it. The wind's dropped now, so let me get that image. Now I'm going to bracket the shot as well, because we've got a bit of ambient light coming up in from the top left-hand corner, which I might crop out or might be able to deal with. But I don't want it blown out. That's what I definitely don't. A bit light behind me now is blown out. Yeah. What do you think? What do you think? Sort of hot, isn't it? Yeah, so I've not lost any weight, no. Before you say anything, before you say in the comments, God, you look fantastic, Steve, you've really lost loads of weight. I haven't, not at all. If it looks like I've lost weight, then this was worth every penny. Because what it means is I can eat exactly what I want and still look fabulous. Yeah. Okay, so, yeah, I love the image completely. I remember when I come here last time, I love that little bit of ambient light it comes through and it casts them odd little shadows. What I would like now, to be honest, was a bit more, I want a little bit harsher light. I know Martin's preferring this light, but I want it, I don't want harsh light, but I want just a little bit more. I just want that little bit more. But it is stunning, stunning shot. I think what I'm going to do then is, because I'm actually cold. God, it's nearly midsummer. We're certainly coming towards the end of spring. I'm bloody freezing. 2 days ago, it was red hot. Okay, that image in the bag. Let's move on and get some more. So we've actually come a walk up to the end where the farmhouse is, and you can't walk any further that way, but there is a footpath where you can walk down into this field here. Now in this field are some lovely lone trees. Not today, but this is a scouting mission today, and we've come for that reason as much as anything. But there's some lovely lone trees in this field, and in the right conditions, they would be absolutely stunning. They'd be
absolutely stunning, superb.
And it's some that I hadn't spotted last time I come here, because it was that foggy, I probably couldn't see them, to be honest. I know there's a couple more lone trees here, but they're more interesting to me. Got a nicer shape to them. The field's quite nice, so the crop needs to be right, and the day needs to be right. Beautiful, yes. Lovely autumn when the leaves will be changing. Again, you would have to really time it right. That's really nice. But yeah, we've come to the end of this part of the road. It is it's a private road with public access. So we can walk literally to there, then we go down the gate and footpath carries on. I'm gonna walk just back down this bend, around the corner here, probably down to this other section where it sort of splits into two, and then I'm gonna get a few more images. And again, I was hoping for that little bit of extra ambient light, that touch more. I'm not sure if we're actually going to get it. Never mind. That's okay. Okay, so we've had a little discussion about the composition of this area, actually this road and these trees.
And it is a difficult place, isn't it?
It is, yeah. It's not just a road with trees,
no,
is it?
It's more than that. It's all about, you know, you get your camera and you move it a little bit this way, and
yep,
a little bit that way, a little bit higher,
yeah,
just to try and get that separation between the branches. And I don't think we're going to come away with some fantastic images from here this morning at all, because the lighting just doesn't work. But it really gets you thinking about composition.
I'm not going to put it up on my video, but if you want to watch Martin's, I'll put a link to Martin's, watch that. But I honestly think it's really interesting how we're trying to compose these images and the problems we got. And it's not just as simple as getting the tripod out, bang, shot, done, let's move on. It really isn't that simple. And we probably spent half an hour just on this one composition, if not longer, actually. And even then you think, is it quite there? And we're still waiting for different things as well, light and things like that. So yeah, have a look at Martin's channel and have a look at the discussion. It's well worth it. Okay, so I was going to move on. The light's come out a bit, so I've taken a couple more images. But I like this one. And what I've done is, I've forgot this right-hand side. I've taking it basically out of the image, and I'm focusing on this left hand side. And one reason why I like it now, because of the light. Within this field behind, there's the odd pocket of rapeseed, and we've got all this green and this little burst of yellow on the left hand side, and that's what's drawing my eye to it. So that's what I've tried to focus on. I like the ambient shadows that are cast across the where the trees are, and now that because this is all gets cut, all this grass in between gets cut, and now they've tucked in and out and created sort of contrast within the grass here. It really does look nice, especially with that little bit of nice light. I love all the green, the different shades of green and everything. So hopefully that's worked, and I'll put that up now. Thank you. So we've come back down to the sort of entrance to this tunnel of trees, and I just can't quite get in a position that I'm happy with. I have took some images, and I'm really waiting for that little extra burst of light that we had sort of once, but I weren't quite prepared for it. We're still getting a nice little bit of ambient light up in the middle distance here, up on these grasses. It's quite nice, but I don't know, I'm not quite feeling it down this end. Probably going to end this video here. I hope you've enjoyed this, because this is a beautiful location, and it's just a shame that we would move on to Chesterton Windmill, but the sails are still not on the windmill. But like I said earlier, we might start. I've got a plan for that, and I might just get a roadside shot and try something out. So I've had a little plan. We're not far from Chesterton Windmill, so we've pulled up here literally a minute down the road. And there's no sails on the mill. There hasn't been for a long while now, for about 2 years actually. But I'm going to use that. What's that AI called?
Generative fill AI.
And we're going to try it and see if we can put the sails back on. Probably won't work, but we'll see how good generative fill is. And it's just such a shame that it's not on, because the field's lovely. It's got some lovely tracks leading up to it, just with no sails, so it just ruins it without sails. Let's see how we get on, and you never know. You never, ever know. Hope you've enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.